why is this car so desirable? It's desirable because of this. It's one of 375 cars delivered. It has full UK service history. It's never left the UK. Full UK service history. It has a McLaren extended warranty. It's the highest spec P1 for sale anywhere in the world today. And it's £150,000 cheaper than any comparable car. Welcome back to another episode of our YouTube channel. Today we've changed it up a bit. Instead of doing it on our hypercar floor, we've gone downstairs to the basement. As you know, we have three floors of supercars here. I thought this is just a different scenery and you can see what else we've got to offer. Today we're talking about a very special car, very special spec, McLaren P1 MSO. So this particular example is a 2014 McLaren P1 MSO, McLaren Special Operations. Now, what MSO do for McLaren is they sort of do whatever you want them to do. If you want your car to be different to any other car out there, you send it to them, or McLaren sends it to them as part of McLaren, and they give you a bill as long as your arm, but you can customize the car to whatever you like. So this car's had the benefits of a full MSO specification. It's done 4,500 miles from new. It's UK supplied, which is great. Obviously we're in the UK, a UK supplied car is always worth more than a car sourced from another country. And what was done by MSO? Well, the color to start off with, blue alpha. It's the only McLaren P1 delivered in that color, which is it's incredible. You got a one of one. The first owner of this car who spec'd the car had a McLaren F1. And he went to McLaren and said, look, this is my F1. I want my P1 to match. So they done exactly what they could to get the P1 to match the F1. What that consisted of, quite shortly, is, as you know, you open up the engine bay of a McLaren F1 and it's a gold-plated heat shield around the engine. Same on the P1. I've never heard of another P1 with that. This P1 has a gold-plated exhaust heat shield that goes around the car, which looks amazing, contrast against the blue. Instead of the snorkel at the top being exposed carbon fiber, like every P1 is exposed carbon fiber, this is painted in blue alpha. The window surrounds, instead of being your black or your chrome or your polished, they're blue alpha. Everything above shoulder height when you're sitting in the car is matte carbon. Everything below that is gloss carbon. Painted pinstripe that goes along the side of the car, that's painted into the car. The list goes on and on and on and on. Wasn't a fan of the McLaren emblem that the modern McLarens have. He wanted the traditional McLaren F1 badge. That was done at a cost of, I think, £7,000 to have that. The Bruce McLaren badge at the back of the car, once again, £3,500-£4,000just for that badge, but he wants what he wants. Whenever you talk about P1, you have to mention a LaFerrari and a 918. As everyone knows, these three cars were the holy trinity, as it were, when they came out. They all came out end of 2013, sort of onwards. And it was, you know, just a comparison one against the other. This one's better than that one in this direction, and that one's better than this one in that sense. They're all very different. They're all great and all better than each other in certain elements. As I've discussed before on P1s, to drive, if you're a driver and you like to drive, is probably the most ruthless out of all of them. There is no room for error in one of these cars. A 918 is so easy to drive. It's just incredible. Four-wheel steering, the traction control is fantastic. It literally sticks to the floor. LaFerrari sits in the middle, where it can go sideways if you want it to. The P1 goes sideways if you don't want it to, and that for me is exciting. You've got to be on your game to drive a P1 hard. But I mean, it looks absolutely fantastic. They're very spec conscious and color conscious, these cars. I've seen some that you look at and you think, wow, that looks amazing. And then others, you could literally park it next to it and you'd be like, wow, that's a bit bland. You know, it doesn't, you know, it's just a standard P1. And the more rare these cars are getting now, because they're obviously, they're finding new owners, they're going to different countries, they're not coming up for sale. And there's only 375 of these delivered worldwide. It's the special cars people are really after. You know, it's the cars that differ from the rest that makes them appealing. So when these cars were launched, you know, there was a lot of hype around what would be the Holy Trinity. You know, McLaren taking on Porsche and Ferrari, the big boys. You know, Porsche and Ferrari have gone head to head for many years. We go back to the 959 versus the F40, to an Enzo versus a Carrera GT. You know, where were McLaren at this point? They'd made the F1, arguably the greatest road car ever produced. But that was it. You know, that was what they had. Apart from their motorsport heritage, that was their road presence. So when they sort of tried to go head on head with Ferrari and Lambo and Porsche with the McLaren 12C, the car was a bit premature. It wasn't really finished, and I think they rushed it and they put it out there to the market, and there's a few problems, and it got sort of blown out the water by a 458 Ferrari. 458's a better car. When McLaren announced the P1 to go head to head against the LaFerrari, which is the new version of an Enzo, people thought they could be in trouble here. You know, you're in the big leagues now. And they decided to make less cars than Ferrari and Porsche, for obvious reasons. 375 in total versus 500 LaFerraris, or 700 if you include the Apertas, and 918 918s. When the car came out, the majority of the reviews were, McLaren have cracked it, that's the one. You know, none of the other two wanted to go around a track compared to the McLaren. I think McLaren were the only ones that were saying, yeah, you know, we'll compete. Get all three of us around the track and let's compete. They didn't really want to know much about it. They had nothing to win, they only had to lose. So McLaren really established themselves with this car going forward into producing road cars. Off of this car, they made what they call the 675 LT, which, in my opinion, a 675 LT and a McLaren are almost like they're built in a different factory to the rest of the McLarens that are made. I mean, these cars are absolutely faultless. They're incredible to drive. The balance, the power, the handling is just absolutely phenomenal. And the rest of McLaren just, you know, they can be great cars, but they lack that little something that a 675 LT and a P1 has. So when this car came out, they sold instantly. You know, you couldn't get them, and you know, the prices went up to, I mean, they're £1 million car, the prices went up to 1.6, 1.7, literally overnight. We've sold them for that kind of money. Over time, like pretty much everything has over the last couple of years, everything's come back and come down, and they've found their feet. And you still see people advertising them for 1.3, 1.4, even 1.5 sometimes, but that's not the true realistic value of these cars. We do well with P1s, anywhere between 1.1 and 1.250. If it was a delivery mileage UK supplied car, it would be sort of 1.250. This car's got 4,500 miles on it. It's a special MSO car, and it's up for sale at 1.1 million. McLaren P1 is a hybrid car, and they came with a 3-year warranty that covers engine, battery, everything that is to cover. When the warranty ran out, people were very nervous about all hybrid cars, whether it be LaFerrari, 918, P1, you know, what's going to happen? We're in uncharted territory here. How much is the battery if it goes wrong? Can you get one? Is it likely to go wrong? When it's the manufacturer's problem and it's under warranty, it's not a worry. But when it's not and it's yours, it can be a worry. What this car benefits from, which is very rare, is an extended McLaren warranty that covers absolutely everything as it would from new. And that's a big selling point on this car. It's a very expensive thing to have. But in order to have that, it needs full McLaren service history. So it needs to be serviced every year on the dot, by a McLaren dealer. If there's anything that needs to be done that's not under warranty at the time, you have to do it before McLaren put an extended warranty on the car. They run it through their workshops. They pick out every fault that would differ from new. If the car wasn't like it when it was new, they won't put a warranty on it. So everything has to be made absolutely as new. Then they will put a warranty on it. So this car benefits from that. So don't take my word that it's a great car. You know, take McLaren's. We've had recently, we sold a silver McLaren, which was lovely. It was Supernova Silver, which is a McLaren color. Had black inside, orange calipers. You know, it looked nice, looked really good. But when you stand it next to an MSO car, you see where the money's gone. You see where someone's thought about their spec. They haven't just said, oh yeah, I'll have a silver McLaren with black interior and orange calipers. That's how you would spec your Volkswagen Golf. You know, like, yeah, I want a silver one, black inside, I want those wheels kind of thing. When you go to MSO, you go to the headquarters, you sit down, they show you thousands of color samples, they show you thousands of interior samples. And then you say, right, I want that color on there. Oh yeah, but we've never done that before. Okay, well, that's why I'm here. So put that color on there. And they make it happen. But like I say, they're not shy. You know, they give you a whopping bill at the end of it. But hey, look, it's better to have than not to have. And at the secondhand prices that these McLaren P1s are down to at the minute, I'd rather have it than not have it. So the total cost for all the MSO options together, separate from the price of the car, was £200,000. Over £200,000, actually. That was the cost to MSO for all the bespoke options. I mean, £200,000 gets you a nice car, gets you a really nice car. And that's what you've just added onto your £1 million car. You know, McLaren, Rolls Royce, Ferrari, when you get into their bespoke spec settings, which a lot of manufacturers do it now, you can really just go to town. You can do and have whatever you want. Well, is this an everyday car? It depends who you're talking to, really. I drove a Veyron nearly every day when I had one, so I'm probably not the best person to ask. I'll probably drive it every day. But no, it's not. It's, you know, it's someone's fifth, sixth, seventh car. You know, it's a lot of people who would buy this kind of car have car collections. You know, it doesn't have to necessarily sit in the collection and not move. And I wouldn't suggest that. I mean, it's a waste to have a P1 and to never drive it. You know, that would be just a terrible shame. But they're very usable. They've got adjustable suspension. You come to a sleeping policeman, lift the suspension up, it's fine, you can do what you want. It's relatively easy to drive it, and there's full automatic gearbox. Visibility is really good out the car. I mean, there's no reason why you couldn't take this car anywhere. But you wouldn't want to be using it every day. So if you're interested in this incredibly stunning McLaren P1 MSO, full details are on our website with pictures. Email us, give us a call, tomhartley.com, or follow us on Instagram, and subscribe to the YouTube channel.